This print illustrates the muscles of the back. It's one of 20 illustrations to a medical treatise about human muscles. It's in life size and it's printed in color, which was a revolutionary new technology at the time. Because it was an illustration to a medical book, it was included in a folded bound volume. So you see the seam across the middle, that's the fold of the sheet of paper. It was meant to be viewed in that way. So rotated at 90 degrees, you would first confront this illustration, turn the page, and then read the text that accompanied it. The text explains what all the different parts of the form are. So they're all identified with letters and with numbers. This is based on the body of a young girl, a dissected young girl, in fact. And the drawing, the representation of all these, of the bones and the structures and the muscles, was based on the study, the careful study, of a dissected young woman. The name of the anatomist who made those drawings is identified here, along with the name of the artist who made the print. The print is not just about science, however. It's not just about anatomy. It's a conflation or a mixture of art and science, because we're not just looking at the muscles of the back or the structures of the bone, but we're also looking at a seated young woman. This portrait comes from a painting that was known to artists in the 18th century, and an ancient Roman painting, which many artists afterward had also copied, including Raphael. It was a painting of one of the Graces. So the choice to include that specific portrait in this medical context adds, the authors said that it added, some sort of beauty, but that allusion to potential eroticism is extremely uncomfortable and difficult to behold. The surrealists in the early 20th century were really disturbed by this composition, and there was a poet who named this figure the anatomical angel as a derogatory claim, because it looks as though the back has been opened up, like wings. And it truly is disturbing the more you think and look at this figure. The text specifically says that the figure, the woman, is looking behind her. So she's not looking off to the side, but looking behind, perhaps implicating us in this live dissection. To acknowledge that, or to think about that, the more one ponders those two things in combination, or rather those multiple things in combination, the potential eroticism, the attempt at some sort of beautification, with all of this medical information and this very, very privileged view of this figure's insides. Not all those things sit together so comfortably, especially for us modern viewers. One of the things we have aspired to do is to place these beautiful objects in multiple contexts, to consider them from many different points of view, and often to confront and think about what makes us uncomfortable today in these historic works of art. And one of the things we're doing in this exhibition is confronting these beautiful works of art, these modern technologies, with historical realities, with a broader context, and not allowing this uncomfortable combination of aspects to sit unchallenged.